What's going on, YouTube, man? It's your boy Junior here, bringing y'all back with another reaction video, bro. We got Uncle Ruckus for part two. You know what I'm saying? Funniest moments, man. Hey, bro, let's react, bro. If y'all fuck with these videos, make sure y'all leave a like, bro. You know what I'm saying? Subscribe to the kid. You know what I'm saying? Subscribe to your boy. That's it. Let's get it.
White women want to go to a basketball game just to see the game, come back with one of them NBA niggas. Out of sympathy. She came to see the game. She wanted to be entertained. Oh, the white woman's got a big heart. Lord, she's got a big heart.
And never married one.
Hold it right down.
And never marry one.
Neighborhood watch. Now, where was you at 11 o'clock last night? Boy, what? Got a big heart.
No snitching.
Hold it right down, boy. Woodcraft neighborhood watch. Now, where was you at 11 o'clock last night, huh?
I was in bed.
No, you wasn't. I seen you with my own eye. You was robbing white people's houses, wasn't you? And oh, look at them wheels. The law say when the bicycle stop, the wheel's supposed to stop. You need a special payment for wheels like that. Oh, come back here. I'm calling the police. Stop.
Nah, this episode right here, bro.
May white God bless you, Robert. I came as fast as I could.
So this is the plan, Uncle Ruckus.
Let's get this party started.
You got bad credit, Robert.
Removing an evil nigga spirit from a Negro is as hard as removing a stank from a hunk of shit.
We must. Wait, what?
God has given us the right nigga. A noose, a knife, stick. A brand and iron. These things strike fear into a nigga's heart. A job application.
Nah, niggas getting to that money now. You tripping. Niggas getting to that money now. You bugging up at that part. He bugging.
It's like somebody threw $1 million into the monkey cage at the zoo. It breaks my heart to watch the degradation of this decent play. 5 years old and she ain't married. Then she must be nutty as squirrel shit.
But everything else was so right. And by everything else, I mean her looks. She was fine.
She couldn't look that good. She was black. But I guess if you put lipstick and a wig on a monkey, it could look good too.
Nah, that's fucked up. That's fucked up, bro. Even for Uncle Ruckus, dog.
Hey, old dog. Only stealing and shooting I want to see is up this him b-ball. Your little future ex-con. Game on! When did you get him? Well, I've been at the ticket window all day long, and I don't remember you buying no tickets, Robert Freeman.
I got my tickets online.
Uh-huh. A damn lie. I ain't never met a nigga smart enough to use a personal computer. Not even a Macintosh. I've been waiting on this day since your little uppity ass came into town.
Bro, it's crazy, bro. Why Uncle Ruckus only have one episode like this, bro? Why? Bro, who else Uncle Ruckus, bro? I can't remember who else, bro. Bro.
This is a tragedy. The white man ain't never done nothing to nobody, and he don't deserve this. He'll make excuses. He will use words he don't really know. If he gets really desperate, he may start to rap or dance.
Nah, hey, bro, Uncle Ruckus fucked up for that, bro. Nah, that cannot be true, bro. No.
Oh yeah. There is powerful niggardry at work here.
Who in the hell are you?
Black women just crazy. It's all that stuff they do to their hair: straighteners and relaxers and activators and tight braids. Still look like I ape with a pretty head of hair. White man made you look like a fool. Ain't no surprise to me. All the greatest basketball players have always been white. Still are. Larry Bird, Dirk Nowitzki. Oh, sure, he ugly as hell on the face, but he is white as rice. The art of the nunchaku.
Art of the nunchaku? Wait, did he just break the fourth wall right there? Hold on.
The owner said something racial. I don't know.
Oh, hold on. I know what he said. He said, and I quote, "I don't want no big nigger lips drinking my fine wine." And I applaud him for putting conviction over profit.
Well, they were them Freeman boys. I'm telling you, you can't trust them no nigger.
Yeah, I said it.
Now, Ruckus, that's
sick of all the ads. Just go to activate.com. Activate now. Ad-
crazy.
Who in the hell are you?
Nigga, my name is Father Uncle Ruckus. No relation. In the name of white Jesus and all great white men who have come thereafter, I command our black nigga soul back to the depths of hell.
Is that all you got, nigga?
Oh, no, nigga. That's just the tip of this iceberg. Read, nigga. Read.
That's so crazy. That actually worked, dog. That actually low-key kind of weakened him, dog. That was crazy, dog.
Now, Robert, now. Just hit him with anything. Come on. Everybody join in. Use your powerful hand. Let's whoop this nigga's ass. Repeat after me the holy phrase. Nigga, get your black ass out of here.
Nigga, get your black ass out of here.
Bro, they finna kill Tom, bro. I thought Tom was finna die right here, bro. Wait, what? I don't want to see that fight. They should continue the fight.
Stink meter, you hate black people, don't you?
I sure do. I mean, I hate everyone in general, but black people especially.
And Ruckus, you hate black people too.
I wouldn't exactly call them people, but yeah.
Right, and stink meter, I bet you hate rap music.
If you can call that old stinky booty gorilla noise music.
Thank you, booty. I must say, that's a brilliant observation, Mina.
I have forgotten the nigger moment cannot be.
Hey there, Darkest. I heard there was some Katrinians in town, so I brought out my old violin that only plays sad songs. Boo ho ho, nigga. It ain't the white man's fault you dumb niggas don't know that they're winning a hurricane.
Who is he? Oh, long story.
But Mr. Charlie stayed one step ahead, don't he? I can see him now. Guess what? I just saved a bunch of money on my insurance. Cause these dumb niggas didn't know there was wind in a hurricane. Oh, what? What, you got some more sad songs, huh? That what you got for me? Oh, you mad cause your Katrina welfare check ain't showed up yet? Hell, y'all niggas wasn't making but $3 an hour before Katrina.
Damn.
Y'all want $300,000, huh? Ain't that some bullshit?
Yeah, come here.
The owner said something racial. I don't know.
Oh, I know what he said. He said, and I quote, "I don't want no big nigger lip drinking my fine wine." And I applaud him for putting conviction over profit. What? Poor white man. He can't have nothing nice for himself no more. Polo, niggas got to that. Timberland, niggas got to that too. Mercedes, Versace, white women. Niggas, niggas, niggas. No, I don't think we can use the word, and I'll tell you why. Because niggas have gotten used to it, that's why. Hell, they like it now. It's like when you growing crops and you strip the soil of its nutrients.
Uncle Ruckus, bro, you the person that used the word nigga, bro. It's you and Riley, dog.
You gotta rotate your race of slurs. Now, I know it's hard, because niggas just rolled off the tongue, and sweat rolled off a nigga's forehead. But we cannot let that be a crutch, especially when there are so many other fine substitutes. Spade, porch monkey, jigaboo. I say next time you gonna call a doctor a nigga, Tuna
What? It was catch up, Freeman.
It was catch up, Freeman. And he sure wasn't free of niggas. He was catching.
I told you you was lying.
That's not true.
Sure it is. Sure it is. See, back in slavery, when the war made sense, the white man had a problem. Niggas couldn't appreciate shit, so they kept running away. Now, in his strategic brilliance, Mr. Charlie decided who better to catch a nigga than a nigga. So they took a field slave named Catcher Freeman and turned him into the greatest slave hunter who ever lived. Catcher Freeman retrieved over 700 pieces of human property to their respective owners during slavery.
Damn it, Ruckus, you're gonna stop this right now.
Dang, Granddad, I'm trying to hear the story.
Look at that, nigga.
Oh, let me see that nigga flip from tree to tree like on some old Tarzan shit. Wait, bring that back. I gotta see that kid.
I'll be happy to.
This is crazy.
Nobody really knows why Catcher is so good at tracking runaway niggas. Some believe he has supernatural power.
Good job, boy. Give him a biscuit.
One legend said Catcher could actually talk to the dog. Whatever his secret, didn't matter how fast they could run.
Man, this dude is off the chain.
Catcher would find them anywhere.
Oh, that nigga gay.
I don't know. Do you think he
on the train to Fagsville? Absolutely. No doubt in my mind. I'm on the train.
Riley, maybe there's another explanation. Maybe this is some kind of crazy sitcom misunderstanding.
Now, wake up and smell the gate. Time for that little boy to be a grown man. Been over a table with his pants around his ankle. Been entered repeatedly. Last train to Fagotville, even in 5 minutes. 5 minutes in that chocolate tunnel. The time a black baby is born, I'd give him a plasma TV and one channel. BET. Slap it right on the ceiling over the crib. By the time that nigga's 12, he'll be watching it in jail. BET forever. BET. Boombayah. BET. Boombayah. That's the kind of language they understand. I wake up at 4:45 in the a.m. every morning. That's about 12 hours before most niggas wake up.
Wait, what?
12 hours before most. I wake up at 4:45 in the a.m. every morning. That's about 12 hours before most niggas wake up. I am a very spiritual person. I start each day by thanking the white man for the sunrise, for the land I walk on, for the air I breathe. I also apologize for niggas, but Lord knows they ain't gonna apologize for themselves. Hey there, Robert. I'd offer to help you with your bags, but you're a coon.
What's he doing here?
He's your babysitter.
Come on, Granddad. Me and Riley don't need a babysitter. We can take care of ourselves.
Yeah, it's not like we're gonna try to kill each other.
Shut up. Do what Ruckus says and don't mess up my house.
Come on.
Me and this punk fool right here.
Okay, first of all, ain't nobody talking while I'm talking, so shut the fuck up. And I will be sitting you two until your grandfather returns. Your granddaddy picked me because I am a licensed zoologist. I have studied a variety of wild animals, and the African male is by far the most savagely cunning. This is an opportunity to observe you niggas in your natural habitat and collect data. But be warned, whatever chicken you got up your sleeves,
we might. Bro, Uncle Ruggy was a bro. This nigga was bro. This nigga was not right, dog.
White man said, nigga, pick that cotton. Nigga, bail that hay. Hurry up, nigga. That's America you building. And that's exactly what nigga is. It's an American original. To understand the story of Catcher Freeman, you gotta know a little something about slavery. Now, if you think niggas is worthless and lazy today, oh, Lord help me, you should have seen them back in slavery days. Little old Master Colonel and plantation owners like him. Provided darkies all over the South with good jobs, food, housing. I'm telling you, slavery was the best thing that ever could happen to Negro kind.
Okay, first of all, none of that.
You married Thelma and lived a miserable life as a free man in Boston. And that, colored folks, is the real story of Catcher Freeman.
Ruckus, I should kick in your damn door for telling them damn lies.
Come on, you high-yellow niggas always forgetting your
I am not black, nor do I consider myself to be black. Many people mistake me for being Negro because they don't know that I am currently living with the heartbreak of revitiligo. That's a skin condition.
Wait, I never noticed that.
Heartbreak of revitiligo. Being Negro because they don't know
that. I never noticed that. I never noticed the skin bleed. Oh, wait.
Living with the heartbreak of revitiligo. That's a skin condition that's the opposite of what Michael Jackson's got. Every morning I apply this topical ointment made of bleach and sulfur. I like to think it works. Luckily, I hadn't gotten much darker in the last few years. As you can see here, I enjoy building small shrines to certain special white people who are important in my life. This one here is dedicated to John Wayne, great white man. Didn't take no shit from niggas, Indians, nor Mexicans. And this one here is for George Bush the First. Loved him. Now this one here is dedicated to the most soulful soul singer to ever live. That's it, go back. Sayonara, you sorry niggas. White man brought in the whole Gulf of Mexico to wash y'all niggas away, but go on back. You niggas ain't too good at taking a hint now, are you? Go on. Save New Orleans. What they got down there worth saving? What, jazz? Jazz music? I hate jazz music. Sound like a long car accident involving some cats. Hey, y'all seen that movie When the Levees Broke? I got a documentary called When the Levees Gonna Break Again.
What the?
Oh, Lord, why hast thou forsaken me?
Yeah, I work about 32 jobs over the course of a week. I think it's interesting I got 32 jobs and most niggas say they can't find one. Niggas. Now, one of the great pleasures of my day is taking all these pretty little white children to school in the morning. Hey, there, Mr. Billy, good morning. I keep the bus nice and clean for them. These kids, oh, excuse me. Oh, hello there,
whatever.
Miss Madison.
How is my little sunshine?
Whoa, hold it right there.
Hey,
where's
Miss
the gun, huh? Where's the drug? Go on, get out of here. Go do your little hyphy-fifey dances and nigger monkey shuffle somewhere else. This here bus is for kids with a future.
It can't be serious, nah. Right, it can't be serious, dog.
Buses for kids with a future. That's right. Get your lazy ass to some exercise. Y'all should just go be rappers. Get into a beef and then shoot each other. Segregation ruined the American school system. When did test scores across the country drop? After desegregation. When did drug use and violence in schools go up? After desegregation. There were never no white kids shooting up nothing before they started going to school with niggas. These little angels wouldn't even know what a gun was. The white man is a peace lover. People say the key to fixing the problems of Negroes is education. But I say education is not the answer. Why bother? And what do niggas do in college anyway? Oh, they go there. They party. Get drunk for 4 or 5 years and end up just as ignorant as when they came in. It just don't smell the same as black African shit. See, the white man just got a better liver. White man eats his meat raw. See, that's healthier. He calls it tartar. How you doing this time? Eat raw. See, that's healthier. He calls it tartar. White man just got a better liver. White man eats his meat raw. See, that's healthier. He calls it tartar. How you doing this fine day, sir? May I say your dookie smells like sparkling ice water with a twist of lime. See, that's why he don't have to wash his hands neither. Yes, sir, white man has impeccable hygiene. Here it is, my test results. Can you hear my heart beating? Oh, the white man's science is amazing, ain't it? Oh, no. This ain't beating.
Oh no, look, it can't be the infamous. I've been seeing that sound all over TikTok. Oh no, this can't be.
The white man science is amazing. My test results. Can you hear my heart beating?
Oh, man, the science is amazing, ain't it? No, no. This
kid's KDB. African with a 2% margin of error. Why, Lord? Why, Lord? Why? A fraternity of bananas up a tree. Black fraternity should have an African name.
Black like fraternity.
Boogie, boogie, boogie.
Boogie, boogie, boogie.
Hey, I got a black fraternity for you. It's called prison. Jail, fire, jail, nigga. You know.
Jail, fire, jail.
Well, I'm black now. So the first thing I did was quit all my jobs.
What?
I don't know how I'm supposed to pay the bills. Probably have to start selling crack. Or rapping. Or rapping by selling crack. You know, I might not even have revitiligo. Okay, I'm black. What am I supposed to do now? So this is it, huh? Is this what you do all day? Sit there reading books and make you think better of yourself, huh? Black man can't. This is what you do now.
Wait.
Okay, I'm black. What am I supposed to do now?
Look, you ain't feel bad for that nigga, dog. Like.
You do all day, sit there reading books and make you think better of yourself, huh? Black man can't get nowhere with his little pecan sized mind, so now you can read. Now what? What you gonna do now? Oh, Nothing, that's what I thought. You know why? Cause we niggas, both of us, and that's all we ever gonna be. That's all we ever gonna be. So this is what I have to look forward to as a black man. Just sitting around playing PlayStation all day, ooh, waiting for the next Madden to come out. Maybe I should go out and put rims and all kinds of goofy shit on my truck. But this is what niggas do, right? Buy sneakers. Then maybe later we'll buy loud stereos and B-rate women and rap lyrics. Is this the kind of shit you niggas put on your feet nowadays? It looks like a damn astronaut shoot. I'm black. I'm not walking to the moon. I'm walking to the liquor store.
Ruckus, stop. Come on, man.
LeBron James, Allen Iverson, can I get a shoe named after a white man, please?
Excuse me. Doc in the zebra shirt. Can I get a Bruce Jenner sneaker?
Man. That's enough. That's enough. Time out, Negroes. Time out. I can't sit here and let y'all badmouth my president. Did any of y'all niggas hear the president when he said Iraq was central to the global war on terror? Or did y'all miss it because he wasn't speaking in baboon? Instead of sitting around here chopping the Brillo off each other's heads, y'all should take your black asses to Iraq and help fight for our freedom. A little more off the sides, please.
I didn't know about. He messed up your test. Here are your actual results.
Well, I'll be. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! How dare you mistakenly inform a man of his blackness? You should be ashamed to call yourself a white doctor.
I'm sorry.
See, Ruckus, you were worried about nothing.
Well, Wedgie, I must say, for a darkie, you are not that difficult to hang around.
Bruh, I'm sorry, bruh. Bro, fam, how did Boondocks create a character like this? I mean, like, bro. How? Because I don't even know that Boondocks always references something like in the real world. So do you tell me there's people like Uncle Ruckus out there in the world, bro? Oh, no, bro. I hope I really don't meet those people. Bro. It's real talk, bro. But you know what I'm saying? If you guys enjoyed that video, you know what I'm talking about. I'm about to bring part 3 of Uncle Ruckus, man. You know what I'm saying? But it is what it is. But make sure I fuck with the video. You know what I'm saying? I'm out. Peace.